Around 90 kilometers south of Indore, in Madhya Pradesh, are the ruins of one of the most beautiful cities of medieval India, Mandu. Once known as Shadiabad, or the City of Joy, has mesmerized visitors for centuries. Referred to in inscriptions as Mandapa Durga, evidence exists of a settlement here in as early as 550 CE. In 1305, Mandu came under the Delhi Sultanate and was with them until 1398, when Dilawar Khan Ghuri, the then governor of Malwa, claimed independence. He shifted the capital of Malwa from Dhur to Mandu, renaming it Shadiabad. It would remain the seat of the Malwa Sultanate till its capture by the Mughal armies in 1562. The most famous monument here is Rupmati's Pavilion. The love story of Rupmati, a Hindu singer, and Baz Bahadur, the last of the Malwa Sultans, is one of the most popular romances of medieval India. Just below the pavilion is the magnificent palace of Baz Bahadur. But the grandest building in Mandu is undoubtedly the Jama Masjid. The inscription on the doorway of the main porch says that it has been modeled on the Great Mosque of Damascus in Syria. What makes the mosque so spectacular is the sheer number of domes. Of the original 162 domes, 96 survive to this day. These domes were not merely decorative, but part of an acoustic system to ensure that the Imam's voice was heard right across the large mosque. Another of Mandu's most famous monuments is the Royal Enclave, comprising of gorgeous palaces, pavilions and tanks. Take for example the Jahaz Mahal or Ship Palace, located between two tanks, Munja Talao and Kapoor Talao. Or the beautiful Jal Mahal adjoining it, named so as it is surrounded by water. The Hindola Mahal or the Swing Palace was the Darbar Hall of the Malwa Sultanate. Its name comes from its slanting walls, which make it appear like a swing. Finally, there is the Chappan Mahal, originally a tomb which was converted into a hunting lodge by the Maharajas of Dhar. Today, the Mahal lodges an archaeological museum. The medieval city hides many more treasures just waiting to be discovered. And this is what makes Mandu so magical.